Hello everyone, this is Dr. Divya. So today I'm going to talk about central serous retinopathy. So as the name says, we know it is a condition of the retina. So we see a serous fluid accumulating in the retina. So this is called serous retinopathy. And since it happens in the center of our retina, it is called central serous retinopathy. So usually we see this condition in middle-aged men who are very stressed out. So very, very typical presentation is they come with a blurring of vision in one eye. So whenever we ask about, you know, stress and all, everybody surely has the same answer, saying that off late they've had increased amount of stress at work or at home. So this condition is very, very typical in the middle-aged men. And so apart from blurring of vision in one eye, we see people complaining that, you know, the vision is distorted. They have a pretty decent vision, but then distorted in the sense a straight line looks curvy or a distortion is seen. And sometimes they see objects much smaller or much farther than they actually are. So these are some of the common complaints, and some complain of a dark spot in the vision, or some just say everything is, you know, little more darker than usual. So these are the complaints that we usually keep seeing, but it typically happens in one eye. So sometimes it gets difficult to even notice, because when one eye is very clear, you know, we usually tend to ignore the blurred eye. Yes, when people notice, they do notice a significant decrease in vision. Their vision drops by about 50%. So like I said, stress is one of the most common factor. Apart from stress, steroid usage is also one more common causative factor. So steroids can be in the form of tablets or nasal inhalers, or it can be in the form of creams that we apply to the skin, and you know, many other forms of steroid usage. So in these people also, we very commonly see this condition. And apart from these, there are other rare conditions where we keep seeing this, like for example, people using hair dyes. And also off late, I'm not pretty sure about this, but then I had people coming to me who are well built, well trained, and you know, they usually, these people are on protein supplements. So I have noticed a couple of, you know, patients coming to me who are like building their muscle using supplements. So I think that also is one of the factor causing this. This condition we see in about 10 people per 1 lakh population. So it's not that rare also. So whenever we see patients of this condition, we usually reassure the patient, because it's usually self-recurrent. It's nothing to worry. So eventually the fluid drains on its own. So we just put them on, you know, some medication in the form of drops, and then we just observe for a couple of months, and it usually goes away. But in very rarely, some patients, you know, do have existing visual symptoms, which takes much longer time, or sometimes we may have to inject. Okay, that will reduce the fluid faster. And also some patients come with recurrence of this condition. So usually it comes down like in a couple of months, it totally, you know, gets all right. And then again, they come back with a similar condition in the same eye, or sometimes the other eye. So when it's recurring so much, then we usually do certain tests to know where this fluid leakage is happening from, and then we can actually use a laser called a micropulse laser to just stop the leakage if it's coming from a same point all the time. So we do this test and then decide what treatment is to be done. But usually it's a very, very small problem, nothing to worry, which gets resolved over.